What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Today we're doing a little experiment. I asked AI to build a microservice in Spring Boot. Nothing extreme, create an order, then pay or process that order. Pretty standard stuff, and in typical AI fashion, it gave me code that works, compiles, and looks perfectly confident until you actually read it. The entire microservice was a couple classes that tried to do everything. Business logic, validation, talking directly to the database, formatting responses, error messages, you name it. It was the god of all classes. Minimal separation of layers, no DTOs, no tests, no proper error handling, duplicate logic everywhere, and one method, a single point of failure. Think of a restaurant where one guy is the chef, the waiter, the cashier, the cleaner, and the delivery driver. It might work on an empty day, but the second customers show up, everything collapses, and that's what happened here. To be clear, this isn't because AI is dumb. It optimizes for the shortest path to something that compiles. It doesn't reason for maintainability, scalability, or testability. AI just wants it working like a student cramming for finals. And here's the twist. If I had told the AI, build a clean order microservice with a controller layer, a service layer, a repository abstraction, DTOs for requests and responses, custom exceptions, validation annotations, a strategy pattern for different order payment methods, and unit test everything, it would have done exactly that. But that sentence alone requires a person who already understands all those concepts. A beginner doesn't know how to ask for validation or abstractions. To them, build an order microservice sounds complete, and that's how sloppy code sneaks into production. So I ran the experiment again, but this time I used a structural prompt. First, it separated the layers, controller for incoming requests, service for business logic, repository for persistence. Then it removed all the duplicated logic and replaced the if-else and hard-coded mess with the strategy pattern so that each payment method has its own isolated implementation. Suddenly, the microservice became testable, extendable, and understandable at a glance. If the business decides tomorrow to add email notifications or database logging, we extend our code and nothing else changes. No digging inside a thousand-line monster, no testing the entire application just because one condition changed. Scaling becomes predictable. Debugging becomes faster. The code base becomes something you'd proudly hand over to another engineer instead of apologizing for it. Keep in mind that even the improved version of the code can be optimized further if you know what you're doing. And that's the entire point. AI can write code, but it can't architect a system. It applies solid principles if you ask it, but does not understand these principles. It doesn't know what happens in a real production environment at 2 a.m. when one bad method crashes a database connection pool and 50,000 users are staring at errors. And that's why established principles, patterns, and best practices are not going away. They are not fancy academic decorations. They are survival tools. They exist so we don't keep reinventing chaos. The strategy pattern exists because business rules always change. The factory pattern exists because object creation gets complicated. The observer pattern exists because systems need to communicate without becoming hardwired. If that language sounds boring, wait until the day you get a ticket labeled urgent production down, and suddenly patterns and practices sound like the greatest invention in human history. People love asking, do I still need to learn design best practices and patterns now that AI exists? The answer is yes. Actually, yes, more than before. Because here's the truth no one wants to hear. AI makes good engineers faster, and it makes bad engineers dangerous. If you know architecture, you can use AI as a power tool. You write a clear prompt, you review the output, you refactor, you enforce patterns, and AI becomes your assistant. If you don't know architecture, you paste vague prompts, copy whatever comes back, deploy it, and boom, congratulations, you just built a ticking time bomb. The difference isn't the AI, it's the person who uses it. So, no, solid design patterns and software architecture aren't outdated. They have become prerequisites. You can't tell AI to use clean architecture if you don't know what clean architecture is. You can't request a certain pattern if you have no idea what that pattern does. You can't ask for separation of layers if you think service class is the only layer in existence. AI isn't replacing engineering, it's exposing who actually understands it. And that's why the fundamentals still matter, maybe more today than ever before. Principles turn code into software, and that's something AI alone still can't do. Going forward, developers aren't replaced by AI. Developers using AI replace the ones who don't know what they're doing. Moral of the story, AI can write code, but engineers build software. And here's where things get interesting. Everything we just saw, the messy code, the refactored architecture, the difference between good output and garbage, that gap is not magic. That gap is the prompt. If you give AI a vague request, you get a vague code. If you give AI a structured, detailed, well-thought-out prompt, you get structured, detailed, well-thought-out software. Which means prompt engineering isn't about tricking AI. It's about thinking like an engineer before you ask AI to act like one. It's learning how to describe patterns, constraints, boundaries, layers, responsibilities, and expectations in a way a machine can execute. It's learning how to turn build me this thing into build me this thing the way a senior engineer would. And that's exactly why we're starting this new prompt engineering series. Not to teach you magic keywords or secret hacks, but to teach you how to communicate with AI like someone who actually understands software. Because the real power of AI isn't what it writes, it's what you tell it to write. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.